everybody, and welcome back to Krimzon Plays Assassin's Creed. Now, last week I did kind of promise that I would have the, little tidbits of Assassin's Creed Rogue to show you. Basically, I wanted to show you that I have unlocked all the things. Long story short, I did not have as much time during this last week as I thought I would have to dedicate to that, essentially. And so I don't have that. But we are going to start Assassin's Creed Unity anyway, and I will show you guys that when I have a second. Or when I get it done, I mean. But anyway, before we get properly started, this week is Yvonne B's stream anniversary. So, you guys should absolutely check out twitch.tv/YvonneB. It's that one right there. Be sure to check her out and give her congratulations for 3 years on Twitch. It's also her birthday week. Like, her birthday was yesterday, I believe. And basically, she's got a whole week planned of stuff, and you should absolutely absolutely check her out this week if you get a chance. In fact, to that end, she and I will be doing a special stream tomorrow. So instead of Tomb Raider Tuesdays, it will be that, essentially. Yeah, but anyway, other than Yvonne B, you should also check out my link tree right down there at the bottom of the screen. Also in that link tree is my Patreon, where you can support me directly if you so choose. Patreon.com/CrimzonKnight, just as exactly spelled like this, and so on and so forth. Do I have any other things to add? I don't think so. You may note that I don't have Unity sitting here prepped and ready. And the reason for that is because the game pretty much just yeets you directly into the game when you boot it up. Yeah. Anyway, let me quickly check a thing. Settings, okay, I have that correct. All right. I had to do some special, because again, I've played this game and 100%ed it before. I've had to do some fiddling to get it to actually do proper, behave itself and get a new game and all of that. So anyway, let's go ahead and play on that. Come on, game. Come on. There it is. Come on.
Assassin's Creed Unity.
There we go.
The past is not lost. The past lives inside us. Encoded in the double helix are the experiences of our ancestors. After 3 decades of research, our engineers have forged the cutting edge of biotechnological interfaces. We have unlocked the lives of our forebears. We have opened a window into the past. This is Total Immersion Entertainment. With the press of a button, you will experience the most pivotal moments in history. All from the comfort of home. Welcome to Helix.
Power developed by Abstergo.
It's your playground.
Powered by the Animus. Now, I know none of that had subtitles, but that's because you can't get into options until you actually start the game, and I didn't want to hit escape and risk skipping. So before we get started, we're supposed to click on this thing up here, just to be clear, this thing, the tragedy of Jacques de Molay, who I believe is historically known to be the last of the known Templars, like in real life. Triumph of the Borgias, which is obviously something connected to Ezio and them. The Lone Eagle, Haytham Kenway. Murder in the Levant, or Levant, however that's pronounced. That's Altair, obviously. The Emperor's Shadow, that's Xiao Jun right there. Of course, there's Fear and Loathing in Florence, which is more Ezio. Washington and the Wolf, which is Connor. The Liberation of Lady Aveline, which we played technically. Technically, we played Liberation of Lady Aveline. That is Assassin's Creed Liberation. And then we also had the secret truce revealed where she didn't actually join the Templars and then killed. Yeah. And the Devils of the Caribbean, which is that game that we spent all of Assassin's Creed 4 creating, essentially, for Abstergo Entertainment. The Bladed Cross is one we've not had, we do not have a real life version of, I don't think. These three right here were suspected of being upcoming games. They have not come out. I believe the Jazz Age Junkies has a comic or a book released about the actual truth behind the Abstergo game that this is based off of. And I believe the same might also be said about one of these two as well. I don't remember one or both of these two. I don't remember for sure. But anyway. So anyway, obviously, as you can see, all of these are locked because it wants you to play this one.
Last of the heroic Knights Templar, Jacques de Molay was a man of principle, a towering intellect, betrayed by those he trusted. In this episode of Fallen Heroes, experience Jacques de Molay's final tragic hours through the eyes of one of his closest friends and advisors.
Give me just a second. God damn it. Discord shut up. Hey, Queen! Glad you could make it. Glad you could make it. Welcome as we are. So, like, in the previous two games, Assassin's Creed Rogue and Assassin's Creed 4, the modern day character was not a. What was. So, like, 1, 2, 3. Brotherhood and Revelations, you were all following Desmond's story, right? Assassin's Creed 4, you were in the modern day story of the noob. As he was helping create the Abstergo Entertainment game for the Helix system, Devils of the Caribbean. Which I already pointed out down here. Right behind where my camera is, right about there. And then in Assassin's Creed Rogue, we were playing the Numbskull, who was recruited from the game makers to the Violet DaCosta and I forget his name. Otto Berg. They were the two Templars who recruited the Numbskull. to explore the memories of Shay Cormac. But in this game, I/the player of the game am the modern day character, which is an interesting thing to think about. So we are playing the Helix system in the universe of Assassin's Creed, logged into the Helix system, and now we're going to play the tragedy of Jacques de Molay. And yeah. It loading. Paris, France, October 13th, 1307.
Who goes there?
A friend of the temple.
Floirac, the council's message was absolute. You're not welcome here.
I must speak with the Grand Master.
He's in session. They all are. Another day, perhaps.
King Philip disagrees.
Damn you, man. Why you're not rotting in a cell at this moment, I cannot fathom.
Shank.
Betrayed. Draw your swords, men. Defend the temple.
Not you, brother. I have a different task for you. Come with me.
So, real quick, let's just pop in here and mess with some options. Okay, so game options, first things first. Language, blood on, companion app on. We'll mess with that later. Because there is a mobile companion app, which I still have on my phone. It's no longer technically it's no longer technically in service, but it does have some useful aspects to it. Allow the game to upload data to the guide server. Sure. Join in progress silhouettes. No, because I don't want to join anything like that. Sound volume. Title language English, subtitles on, we needed that. HUD yeah, sure. Controls, that's a thing we need to mess with. So apparently this is what I'm looking for. Alright, so WASD, sprint, crouch, jump, hack, interact, relook, drop bomb. Vision. Okay. Life potion, reload, use skill. Okay. That should be good enough for now. Just to quickly pop in here, make sure everything's a copacetic. Yeah. Okay. Now.
King Philip's moving faster than we expected.
Another hand is at work here.
The Pope.
The assassins.
Assassins? I thought the Mongol Khans broke their power decades ago.
The assassins are far older than Masaya. Anarchic delusions are virulent as the plague, less easily eradicated. We will not prevail this night, but if you make haste, we may yet save our order.
What must I do?
Go to the tower. Take the sword and the book. Hide them. They must not fall into the assassin's hands.
Grandmaster, go! I will.
Well, that person had a bad day. Okay, where am I supposed to be going? This way? Okay. Or was I not supposed to jump across? Where am I supposed to be going? Hey, get off. Okay, so no eagle vision yet. That's fine. All right. This is where I was supposed to go, I believe. So, in case you missed it, smoke bomb and then a hooded shadow ran past.
Stop him! Don't let him through.
Am I going the wrong way? No, I'm going the correct way. Come on, give me a chance to parry again. Come on. Okay, or not. So just real quick, something I want to note. The assassin I'm currently chasing and fighting is wearing a blue variation of Altair's style of assassin garb. Because this is 1307, which is near... not long after Altair's era. Is a piece of Eden. Yep. And a book. Codex Pater Intellectus, or something like that. The Sword of Eden. which we knew there was a Sword of Eden before. It was shown in Assassin's Creed 2. St. Joan of Arc had it. And a few others.
Pope Clement, hear me? Before this year is out, you will answer for your crimes before God Almighty! And you, King Philip, no punishment is too heinous for the great evil you have inflicted upon the temple! I curse you! Curse you to the 13th generation of your blood! You shall be cursed!
Consumed in flames of hunger and wrath, thus came the age of true wisdom to a blistering close. The Knights Templar, once the proud shepherds of order, peace, and illumination, were no more.
Again, propaganda written by the Templars.
Let's get a sniffer running. If Abstergo pings us, pull me out. Okay.
Oh, hello.
I have a visual. Hey there. This is probably disorienting, so I'll be brief. I'm Bishop, not my real name, obviously, but that's as much as you'll get today. Please listen carefully. Abstergo is using you, hijacking your neurons to help them sift through genetic memory data. These guys already have their fingers in countless corporations, governments, media outlets, and NGOs. But now, they want control over history itself. If that doesn't frighten you, it should. But we're here to stop them, and I need your help. Deacon, preload gene sequence AD16, B13, I87.
Yep, spooling it up.
Last week, we gained access to a bank of unsequenced memories in Abstergo's Helix servers. For now, we'd like you to experience a small sample. This should help you understand our struggle. And after that, you can decide for yourself what comes next. We'll be waiting.
The voice of Deacon, which we got a very barest glimpse of, is Sean Hastings from the other games. Versailles, 27th of December, 1776. 400-ish years after the last memory we had.
Arno.
Can't I go with you, Father?
Courage, my boy. You wait just here. I will return when this hand reaches the top.
That's forever.
Not as long as all that. And when I get back, we'll see the fireworks. And Arno, no exploring, hmm?
Yes, Father.
We are now about to witness something that we saw from another perspective entirely. At the end of Assassin's Creed Rogue, there is a segment that we played out, that I talked about, that we saw. And now we see it, now we're seeing it from another perspective of somebody else who was there. I won't say more because potential spoilers for what's about to happen. But still, There we go. Come on. In fact, that chair played heavily in that thing. Look at him, he's so cute!
Just you wait till the guards get here.
Quickly.
Ale.
Bet you can't steal one.
Thief! Put that back!
Tutorial for how to break your pursuer's line of sight. Create a last known position.
What happened?
Got you now.
Do you? You sure?
Damn it! The hell's going on?
Kids are faster than old men in armor? Okay, so he can't see me, so I'm just gonna dip into here.
When we stole those apples.
I'm Arno.
Elise.
I'm here.
And during this point in time, a man in a coat, in a long trench coat, walks past somewhere in the background. We won't see him, but he does. Walks down a hallway through a crowd of people. And then proceeds to stab a man.
Aye. He has important business with the king.
What should we do now?
Shh. Listen. Don't worry. They'll never think to look for us in here.
It was my fault. I'm the one who took the apple.
Let's see where they're going.
He was gonna take permission. Not permission, he was gonna take blame for that, except because of what I just said. That's not what is happening.
Monsieur Franklin, I sincerely hope this unfortunate affair does not darken your opinion of our nation.
Monsieur, if we judged nations by the character of their criminals, we should all be called barbarians.
Elise.
Father?
Come here, girl, now.
Father?
Elise is going to her father. We just heard Benjamin Franklin talking to somebody because we know Benjamin Franklin is here because that's how Shay got in here. Into this hallway. Where he stabbed this man, Arno's father. And left him sitting in the chair that Arno was supposed to be sitting in.
Come away, boy.
Arno. Arno. Look at me.
So now we know the importance of that final scene from Assassin's Creed Rogue. Now, 13 years later, 80s, I believe.
That went fairly at cards, so you stoked the thieving, you bastard!
Calm down, Victor. I've only come for my watch.
It's my watch. I want it fairly.
Well, in a just world, Victor, I would agree with you, but this is not a just world. This is France.
You're a dead man.
Ooh, step lightly there. You'll hurt yourself.
I just had a nice chat with your brother.
Hugo, fetch the marshals.
Hold on a minute.
Don't get tackled and pass over slash under five objects.
Pardon, madam. Gentlemen, please, we can come to an understanding. Please, excuse him, he's not housebroken.
Please excuse him, he's not housebroken, he shouts.
Thick-headed blacksmith like you probably can't even read a watch.
Come over here and say that!
No.
No.
Get back here! Over there!
Keeping up? Shall I call a break?
Give me one moment. Yes, Arno is very much one of the sassiest assassins. He and Ezio are both incredibly sassy. Let's go get this viewpoint here, shall we? Actually, one second. Let me go with some Windows stuff. Hold on. There we go. And actually, no, Queen, your spelling of Ezio is absolutely on the money. Oh, there's a chest over here? Fine, don't go that way. Yeah, the Ezio as a name is kind of exactly how it sounds. Just a second. Can Connection successful. Unity companion app has successfully connected to your PC. Hey, there we go. So I now have access to the companion app on my phone. Doesn't really do much at the moment. It works as a map, so I don't have to go in here, you know? All right, now where do I want to jump? There's where I want to jump. Ooh, look at that eagle vision. All right. Now then, where was I going? This way, I was going this way.
And where in God's name have you been?
Ha! Got you now, you little shit!
Just a little misunderstanding. Nothing to...
Your master's harboring a common criminal. In broad daylight, he broke into my home and stole my watch.
Did he indeed? Well, I'm sure the Marshalsea would be more than willing to sort this out.
Sort what out, Olivier?
A most serious accusation against your ward, sir.
He robbed me.
Of what, precisely? Wait for me in my library.
Of what? Ooh, that's a painting.
Don't give me that look. Victor cheats when he plays Pharaoh. Everyone knows it.
Arno? Who are you talking to?
No one, monsieur.
You'll be happy to learn I persuaded Olivier to leave off calling the Marshalsea. Again.
Again.
Je vous remercie, monsieur.
What is this? The sixth time? The seventh? Perhaps a new hobby might be better for your health.
Well, I find playing cards affords many opportunities for fresh air and exercise.
We'll talk about this later. I have business in town and must collect Elise before I can attend to it.
Elise is here?
Only for the night. She returns to Paris first thing tomorrow.
She'll need an escort, won't she, with you so preoccupied?
One of you running amok is quite enough. Remain here and see if Olivier has any chores for you.
Sure he does.
What was that?
Give my regards to Elise.
So yeah, the little girl that he was playing around with, that he was playing with and stole apples for back at Versailles when his father died, she and her father took him in and raised him after his father died. All right, so before we go do that, I'm gonna do some running around. Get used to the game and stuff. Best here somewhere. Something up there. I think that might be the chest I'm looking for. Ah, no, there's the chest I'm looking for. So, because this is the Helix system rather than the Animus, they once again have completely revamped the control scheme. So excuse me while I, you know, relearn how to play the game. Come on. Why are you not letting me? Why are you not letting me? Fine, whatever. All right. Now there should be. Ah, there. Okay. All Alright. Okay, so the viewpoint for the district is all the way down there. So let's run. I don't know why I'm using the in-game map when I can be using my mobile companion app. I just used my phone to create a waypoint. Technology. Old technology at this point, but technology. Nonetheless. Pardon me, coming through. All right, and then there's another chest up. Okay. How to get in there? Ah, window. In? Ah, a locked door. Not pick locks without the lock picking skill. Okay. Well then. Is there another way in? Maybe on the other side of the building. Oh my, yes there is. Right there. Now, I'm not going to do all of this stuff running around today. Because, like it said, there's some stuff that I can't get here because I don't even have the lockpicking skill for it. But I did want to get a few of these chests and at least get a handle on the controls, you know? Before I progress the game too much further. Kevin? Now, I do want to get this viewpoint. Pardon me, coming through. Me. There's a collectible right here that I'm running past, so let's go ahead and grab that. It's not there, it's over here. Question mark, please. Climb the tree, Arno. Thank you. There it is. All right. On me, monsieur. Mon ami, monsieur, just passing through. Oh, down. All
up.
Queen, I think you're gonna like... Well, maybe not, actually. I forget. What are your opinions on stories like, tragic romance stories? Well, just tragedies in general, I guess. Not a big fan of tragic romances. Got it. Wow, that was a loud-ass car that just drove by. Feel it rumbling all the way through my fucking desk. Oh shit, my mic actually picked it up. Dang. Oh, wrong button. Ooh, that's trippy. My jump right behind me, it looks like. Yeah.
Move on.
Just want to interact.
Let me interact with it.
Fine. I guess the blue ones I can't interact with yet. For whatever reason. All right. A waypoint over here. I don't remember. Are the blue... Hold on. Let me check something. Are the blue ones requiring a lockpick? They're nomad chests. Oh. Got it. Right. Okay. It must be a thing that I can open and start doing later. Either that or I just can't... Either that or I'm forgetting something. That jump gave you hella anxiety? Oh, you mean the leap of faith? And yeah, this game has a lot of gorgeous views. Collectible around here somewhere on the other side of this building. Got it. Look at this architecture and design. What's the word I'm looking for, Queen? What's the word I'm looking for? Other than beautiful, what's the word I'm looking for? Of the specific kind of design, I mean. not just describing how it that it's aesthetically pleasing. Revolutionary France era type stuff. Very French. Yeah, I'll take that. Close enough. Just a second. Okay. Yes, I know. I've already unlocked that collectible. You don't have to tell me that when I literally just got it. But the game's like, no, I do have to tell you that. Oh, it wants me to go over there. Royal. Yeah, actually, yeah, I think royal is the word I was looking for. Allow me to just like lurk as these two, you know. So you two aren't upset about having an audience for this, like, you guys came up to a fucking attic, like, through a hatch door and everything to have this conversation. And you guys don't mind at all that there's just a third person just standing here chilling, watching and listening? So very French. Like, he keeps shushing her, too. You know? Like, he keeps shushing her, too. Regal, thank you! Yes, that is exactly the word I was looking for. Don't mind me, fellas.
I'm a good guy! Good at smashing! Rip! You! Yeah, you! Stop that!
I'm leaving. See? I'm gone. Don't have to worry about me. Oh, wrong button. But yes, it's incredibly French that those two lovebirds were having that kind of hushed whisper kind of conversation with me right fucking there and did not give a shit about me being nosy as fuck. This game is gorgeous. This game is gorgeous. That didn't. There we go. It didn't take. We do. Up, 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 up. How's your day been, Queen? I think I forgot to ask that earlier. I know a little bit about how your day was, because you got that good news earlier that you told us all. Yeah. I'm glad that your day at work was good. Especially after that other day a bit ago that was absolutely fucking terrible. Hold on just a second. There we go. Let's just do that. Nice, 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 nice. Oh, hi, guys. Yeah, I think I'm gonna be getting a fight here. My day was pretty good. Yeah, I'm just gonna get fought. I'm just gonna do this fight. Come on. Ow. Ow, stop it. Ow, with the fucking gun?
I'll rip your heart out.
Ow! Oh, was not paying attention. Ah, fuck me! Wrong button. Alright, he's dead. Let's just loot these corpses too. But yeah, my day's been pretty good. It was a little slow, which is why I started my stream a little late. By slow, I mean like I just kinda ended up moving really slow today, essentially. But it was pretty good regardless of that, you know? Next. Pardon the intrusion. Gonna. Alright, so just to give you guys a brief show of, you know, everything of what I have left, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You know what? I am gonna just do them all. Fuck it. I'm gonna do them all. Okay. So I'm nearby where there's. Yes, right over there. I see it on the map. Okay. On the mini map. Ah, right there. That makes it easy. Oh, Arno, that's not what I wanted. Oh, it's my bad. I pushed the wrong button. Come on. There you go. I was gonna say something else to you, Queen, but I don't remember what it was because I got distracted by the game. So if I remember it, I'll say it to you. Otherwise, whatever. Must not have been important. About the game, though, this game is often heralded by a lot of Assassin's Creed fans as the peak of in-game parkour, because of the movement being satisfying and the controls being satisfying once you got a handle on them and all of that. Which is actually kind of fitting, considering the fact that parkour was invented by the French. So it is actually very fitting. That this game is considered to be one of the height of parkour and of the parkour game system. And it's also one of the reasons why they very specifically, when they were making this game, they brought on professional parkour athletes, parkour runners, to watch them essentially perform and mapped their movements and the like for the purpose of the game. Because they wanted to do it right, you know? The alternative to that is that, unfortunately, because of how broken it was when it came out, this game holds the position as the most broken, and thus arguably the worst of the Assassin's Creeds. They shot for the sun and missed, essentially. Now, that said, since the game's initial release, they did do a lot to fix it and make it playable and playable and unbroken. But it still, unfortunately, was branded in that way. You know?
Oh. Mon frère n'est pas loin. Il me suffit de l'appeler.
Je comprends que vous n'êtes pas à la bonne adresse.
Encore un misérable voleur.
Je peux vous aider, citoyen.
Alright. Oh, chill, people. Yeah. There you go. Coming through. Y'all are fine. Ain't gonna hurt y'all. Oop. Didn't mean to drop all the way to the ground, but that works. Oops, sorry. Pardon me. Coming through. Oh, wrong button. Again. There it is. Three more chests. Okay. No, not down the ladder, Arno. Arno. There you go. Here and down. Look at this guy over here. Hey, man, you working hard or hardly working? Oop, wrong thing. Yay! Congrats, Queen! That's a load off your shoulders. Another window? Here we go. There you go. Yeah, I understand. That's what I want. Okay. Now. Alright, so we have one more chest other than the two blues. We have one more chest and one more of those things. Okay. Oui. With the pain and shit. Ooh, with the gun and oof. Loot. Please have medicine. 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 Medicine. Yay. Medicine. Smoke bomb. Okay. Which I don't have any of. All right. Okay, that's all the chests. At least all the ones I can currently get. Sheep, goats, whatever they are. I think they're goats. Ah, hello, fellas. Let me actually talk to you. Yeah, we'll go ahead and refill my consumables. Consumable. Miss Consumable. Alright, let's climb the building, get this collectible, and then continue the storyline, shall we? Oh, I'm still missing a collectible. I'm missing a collectible and I have no idea where it is. Okay. Oh. Okay, well. Oh well. Come on. Do what I'm telling you to do. Okay. And. Oh, pardon me, coming through. Try this again. Can I? Apparently not. At least not right now. Okay. All right. Now there was some golden shit up here that I wanted to take a look at. Oh. All right. Can't interact with it yet. Okay, well, downstairs we go. Monsieur! I was told to ask you for work. Arno. Off the banister, my friend. Some slight semblance of decorum. Please.
Thrown out onto the street yet?
Oh, you would love that, wouldn't you?
It'd break my heart.
Olivier, if I weren't here, who'd do all your work for you?
The horses need brushing, boy. Get to it.
Certainement, monsieur.
Certainement.
Sire, Sire de la Serre, wait! Nom de Dieu. Nom de Dieu, nom de Dieu.
Some trouble, mon ami.
A letter for Sire de la Serre. It's very important.
Oh, calm yourself, Perrault. That letter won't reach Monsieur de la Serre any faster if you drop dead of exhaustion. Give it here. I'll catch
you. You must receive it today. It's very...
Very important. Yes, I heard you the first time. I'll see that he gets it.
Monsieur de la Serre! Stop! Make way, man!
make way.
Don't you just hate it when you have to chase after a horse and carriage?
Monsieur de la Serre. Please excuse, wrong carriage. What I need is a bird's eye view.
Les Miserables. Oh, nope. No sliding down the church. States General, May 5th, 1789.
There you are.
Through here.
Devil are they?
La dette de l'État, déjà immense, à mon avis.
been modern. Une guerre dispendieuse, mais honorable, en a été la cause. L'augmentation des impôts en a été la cause. Inquiétude générale, un désir. Et on finirait par égarer totalement les opinions si on ne se hâtait de les fixer par une réunion d'âmes sages et modérées. C'est dans cette confiance. Avec sensibilité, qu'elle a déjà été justifiée par les dispositions que les deux premiers ordres ont montré à renoncer.
So, who or what will take its place? Another king? A council of capable men?
That is the question, isn't it?
A truce, then.
What the devil was that about?
Now, we can resolve this without recourse to violence, can't we?
Get him, Hugo!
I suppose not.
Get him, Hugo!
Easy, big fella.
Watch me.
Not your day, is it, Victor? To your health, gentlemen.
You, boy, stop! What are you doing there?
Running.
Guards in blue are the police. If you attack or kill anyone in their line of sight, they will attack. Climb, Arno. Climb. Catch him back at home. Hold sprint to and automatically jump. Okay. Hold sprint and space to jump higher and further. Hold shift and E to execute a controlled descent, which is what I've already been doing. All right. Hold on. Here we go. Okay.
Game.
l'air de s'amuser.
Bonsoir, Olivier. Has Monsieur de la Serre returned?
Seigneur de la Serre is not expected until late.
Ah, well. I suppose I'll just pass the time with Elise, then.
Don't get your hopes up just yet. Mademoiselle is at a private soiree, in her honor, at the palace.
A party? I wasn't invited.
Neither were the horses.
I'm sure she just misplaced my invitation. I'll find my own way in. How late is late?
Perhaps an hour, perhaps three, perhaps not at all. I do not question the comings and goings of my betters.
I'll just wait here then.
If he had gone, there's a very good chance he might have, you know, delivered that letter. Assuming it's important. Said to be important.
Mémoire de Monsieur d'Artagnan. Elise's favorite. Le traité du monde et de la lumière de Descartes. Never could get through that one. I could just slip it under the door. He'd see it the instant he returned. Les tragiques. Too depressing. Elise never enjoyed these high society balls. She'll be home soon.
I don't know, man. She was off at finishing school, I think.
Hop, hop.
There. Safe and sound, and only slightly delayed. And now, to the palace. I couldn't sneak through a sewer in these threads. Much less a ball. Here, here, mon ami. Let me take care of that.
Well, thank you, young man.
Cleans up pretty nice, doesn't he?
Maximilien Robespierre. No guest.
Arno. Le Chevalier du Telem.
Invitation, s'il vous plaît.
About that, I had one, of course, but on the web.
No invitation, no admittance. Now clear the queue. Next, please. Charles Gabriel Civet. Two guests.
Robespierre was the first name on that list. Did you if you caught that? All right, hiding place over there. We're about to sneak into the Palace of Versailles. I'm sure that's fine. Sure, that's fine and easy and not a thing that's a problem or illegal in any way, shape, or form. Woo! Fireworks! Look at that!
Let's just put in a short appearance to be polite. I'm tired.
As you say.
Oh, wrong button.
Thank you.
the De La Serre girl.
Some kind of confirmation party for the De La Serre girl. Damn it, I got caught.
Third estate practically up.
Yeah, yeah.
They're having a party.
What's this party for, anyway?
Not sure. Some kind of confirmation ceremony for the De La Serre girl.
Come on, my dude, turn around. You saw nothing.
That's odd. Another nutter escaped from beset.
Just a second. Probably, yeah. Oh, absolutely. I love how he peeks his little head up like that. Yippee!
Same to you. I think I'll stay up here.
You, come here.
I'll see you in the garden later, yes?
Of course.
I can't remember the last time we were all together like this.
Huh. That man right there is a Templar. You can tell because of the cross. And we're all here together like that. This is a Templar party. And it's some kind of a confirmation or something like that for the De La Serre girl. Which means that Elise is getting... confirmed into membership of the Templars. Elise, Arno's childhood friend.
M'accorderiez-vous cette danse pour gentilhomme?
There she is, too.
Merci. Un autre jour.
For sure, the pleb would riot this afternoon.
She always did love the chase.
You seem to have caused quite a commotion.
What can I say?
Notice the cross on her necklace.
Oh, you were a worse one. One of my father's suits.
Are you wearing a dress?
Don't even start. I feel like a mummy wrapped up in this thing.
Must be quite an occasion to get you so fancy.
It's not like that. Truth be told, it's a lot of ceremony and pontification. Dull as dirt.
Well, when you don't invite me to your parties, everyone suffers.
I did try, but my father was adamant.
Your father?
Go. I'll distract them.
What? You're kicking me out?
It's complicated. I'll explain later, but for now, out the window.
Oh, no. You're not turning this into a repeat of that apple orchard.
Stop being such a baby. I'm sure there aren't any guard dogs this time. Go!
Red cross in her necklace.
Now, was
that forbidden
room at all? Was it?
We're pursuing an interloper, Miss Delacere. Have you seen him? Playing stupid.
Oh, there was Madame de Pudinette. Her hair has a bird
in it.
I think she stole it from the royal.
From the royal menagerie.
Please move aside so we may check this room, mademoiselle.
You'll find only me, I'm afraid. I've been searching for the billiard room for almost an hour.
We can show you there, mademoiselle. And we'll lock the door to prevent any further misunderstanding.
I love her. Although she is, like I keep pointing out, wearing a red Templar cross in her necklace.
Could have been on party duty, but no.
Waste of time. There's nobody out here.
There's my door. Don't turn around.
I'm cleaning a rich man's vomit off my shoes.
Wait, staff be like that. Don't turn around. He's gonna turn around. I can feel it. Around. Okay, good. Okay.
You're right, monsieur. Too much of the king's champagne. Monsieur.
Monsieur de la Serre! Monsieur de la Serre! Siva, come away! Guards! Help! Murder!
Bon Dieu! He's killed Lord de la Serre!
Framed with the murder of the man who raised him and took him in after his father died. After his father was murdered. And the father of the girl he apparently is in love with. But, things I would like to point out. The two men, hold that thought. The two men that we saw in the background, the one who said Siver, come away, and then called the guards to the attention of the murder, and then the other one we saw walking away through a gate. Both of those men were the two we saw that we overheard when we first entered the palace, hearing about, we overheard say, will I see you in the garden later, type of a thing, or I will see you in the garden later, whatever it was they said. But also, Siver was one of the names introduced. They were standing behind Arno in line. And then there was also, we also saw that other man somewhere. We've seen both of them multiple times throughout the course of this intro, that section that we just played through, basically, is what I'm saying. Just a second.
No! It wasn't me! Damia wielded the knife! Please! Have mercy!
Gaia est omnis divisa in partes tres.
They're killing us! Oh God, have mercy! They're killing the prisoners in here!
That's enough of that, you degenerate!
It's completely nude. With a well-placed prison bar.
Where am I?
In hell.
In hell. In hell. What's interesting about these markings on the walls? These are all symbols we've seen repeatedly throughout the course of the game, the Assassin's Creed games up to this point. That one over there on the left, the two sets of concentric circles, the monkey with the spinning tail, the mountains, the three triangles. That one's new, I think. But the others were all ones we've seen numerous times. In fact, the three triangles, the monkey, and the weird circles are ones that Subject 16 was the one the predecessor of Desmond Miles in the Abstergo experimentation program. The one who went crazy and slit his wrists and began to paint crazy symbols across the animus room in his own blood. Those were the circles, the monkey, and the three triangles were repeated symbols that he painted in his blood, and thus have repeated throughout the games. Alright, let's talk to this guy over here.
What are you staring at, Pisspot?
Pisspot.
I love his voice.
What are you staring at, Pisspot?
Welcome to your new home.
Bed.
Hello? I must speak to someone. Open this door!
Scream all you like. No one cares.
No one cares.
I must speak with Elise de la Serre. Do you hear me? Elise de la Serre! Elise! Bring Elise to me! I'm no killer!
You're wasting your time.
Qui se ultra morti operant, facilius reperiuntur.
Don't bother me, boy. Sitting. I could kill you 7 ways. 12 if I had a spoon.
12 if I had a spoon. God, I love him. Can I interact with that more? No.
You should feel honored. These days, the Bastille is reserved for madmen, deviants, and traitors.
I'm in the Bastille. Which are you?
If you snore, I'll strangle you in your sleep. That's fair warning.
Yeah, that's fair. Fair, very fair warning. Oh, he has more to say.
What?
Oh, does this guy have more to say?
So the question is, did you kill someone important or fuck someone important? Hmm?
Kind of both, actually.
Not that it makes much difference now. Here we're all well and truly fucked.
Alright, so he doesn't have more to say. These guys don't have any more to say. Alright, let's go to sleep. Let him keep his father's watch.
Where'd you come by this, Pisspot?
I'm in no mood for this. Give it back!
Take it back. If you think you can.
Take the bastard down a peg!
Well struck, Pisspot. See if your defense is as good.
So much effort for a broken antique. The only broken antique in here is flapping his idiot jaw.
Say that again.
I've nothing more to say, old man.
Ten leave, old man.
Give me what's
mine. Dude hasn't touched me.
Go back to your crazy drawings, old man.
Drawings.
These here. Everywhere. Scribbled like chicken scratches all over this cell. Where?
Come here, you little pisspot.
Get your hands off me.
Look at the wall.
What are you doing?
Concentrate. Concentrate.
Yeah, the violin music gives Pride and Prejudice vibes.
Crutch rot spread to your brain already. Focus.
I will focus in a second, but the violin music gives Pride and Prejudice vibes.
What are they?
Messages from the past. I had myself thrown into half the prisons in Paris in search of these. What's your name, boy?
Honor.
It's like it's that same Regency
Honor
era.
Victor Dorian.
Dorian. Of course. Pierre Bellec. I knew your father.
Bully for you.
He died at Versailles. I mean, what? 76? 77? December, as I recall. No witnesses.
How did you...
Your father was an assassin, Arno. He gave his life, fighting for the liberty of all mankind. You stick with me, you might just live long enough to join the Brotherhood. Honor your father's memory.
Listen, I'm sure your little cult is a delightful bunch, but I'm not interested. The only thing I care about is finding Elise.
How are you planning on doing that from in here?
Two months later. So May, June, July.
Again.
Ow.
Focus, pisspot.
What the hell is going on out there?
Citizens are restless. Keep an ear open. Opportunity might just come knocking soon.
The storming of the Bastille.
That was cannon fire.
Sometimes opportunity sounds a lot like cannon fire.
Secure the prisoners!
Follow my lead.
Take cover!
Told you this was going to end badly.
Silence! Stay back! Prisoners up against the wall. Stay back!
Right. Let's get out of this shell.
In your own time. No need to rush on my account. In your own time. You've got to be kidding.
Come on. They're breaking into the courtyard. I told you. You've got to be kidding.
Got it! Let's go, Pisspot!
Come on, Arno. There you go. Wait. I heard a to lockpick it. Okay. So I'll have to come back to the bestie. Okay, fine. Leap of faith, my friend.
I surrender.
Good.
Come on.
What are you waiting for, Pisspot? It's time to jump.
What? Prison scrambled your brains, old man.
Drink took care of that a long time ago.
Get up here!
I can't, that's impossible!
Impossible? That's the purview of every assassin boy! If you can pluck your head out of your own arse, come find us!
Make a great fit.
Goodbye, Pisspot!
You! Back away from the ledge!
Right? Very cool, Queen. Very cool. He probably reeks to high heaven.
That's some welcome.
One can't be too careful. But after what happened...
Elise...
Haven't you done enough to repay my father's kindness?
Elise, please. You can't believe I killed Monsieur de la Serre. Your father... He wasn't the man you thought he was. Neither of our fathers were.
I know exactly who my father was, Arno. And I know who yours was. I suppose it was inevitable. You an assassin. Me a Templar.
You?
Does that shock you? My father always meant for me to follow in his footsteps. Now all I can do is avenge him.
I swear to you, I had nothing to do with his death.
But you did.
No. No! By my life, I swear I didn't! Is that...
A letter intended for my father the day he was murdered. Read it.
Grandmaster de la Serre, I have learned through my agents that an individual within our order plots against you. I beg you to be on your guard at the initiation tonight. Trust no one, not even those you call friends. May the Father of Understanding guide you, El.
I found that on the floor of my father's room. Unopened.
I didn't know.
Neither did my father.
How could I have known?
Just go. Please.
Poor guy. Just a second. Sorry, my phone is arguing with me. There we go. All right.
The devil is this supposed to mean. Paris
is now open. You can now explore the city or play the next single-player mission to continue Arno's story. All right, let's take a... take a look at the map, maybe. Here we go. We have the entirety of Paris. Well, more or less. We are there. Let us go there first. Storming of the Bastille. Her father was the Grand, and was not just a Templar, he was the Grand Master of the Templar Order. And it was not an assassin who killed him, it was somebody within the Order plotting against him. Thank you. Hey, Queen, you still there? What's that? Is that the church? Yeah, that is Notre Dame. Or Notre Dame, whichever the pronunciation is. Yep. Notre Dame during the Revolutionary Era. In fact, I am currently in Notre Dame of the Revolutionary Era. Lots of very angry people outside. And I am now climbing. Yes, so interesting fact. When Notre Dame caught, fire and essentially burned down semi-recently, Ubisoft was one of the people, one of the groups of people who provided scans and information to help the rebuilding effort. The rebuilding and repairing effort. And that is because they did a complete 3D scan, essentially, of, they essentially did a complete 3D scan of the church for this game. And they had those files on hand and provided them. Oop, I didn't want to go down. Up, up, Arno, up. You can't hear me now? Oh, commercial, got it.
Out there, standing in the sun.
Welcome back, Queen. Yeah, you didn't really miss much. All I did was sing a little bit of one of the songs from Hunchback of Notre Dame. Look at that gorgeous, gorgeous view. Now, Queen, if that one jump gave you anxiety, this one might give you worse anxiety. Just warning. You've been looking away for all of them? Fair. Very fair. La Patrio, or however that's pronounced, 1789. Latude escapes again. Years ago, Jean-Henri Latude made quite a career of his exploits, escaping from the prisons in place, Bastille, blah, 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 blah. Marquis de Lafayette has been confirmed as commander-in-chief of the new National Guard. Triggers your fear of heights? Very fair. That is very fair. I should probably actually have a warning for that on my streams, now that I think about it. Refill, because we have the cash. Alright. Now, we were going to go this way. Palais de Justice. I'm probably butchering all the holy shit, dude. Your hat, my guy. Holy shit. Yo. Twins. It's a bitchin' hat. Damn right, queen. Chapelle. Come on, Arno. Climb. Climb, my dude. Climb. There you go. Please. Climb some more. There you go. Up. Again? No? There you go. That's what I was looking for. Alright. Ooh, we can go inside? Ooh, let's go inside a church. The Saint Chapelle Church. Beautiful! Look at that. It's a bit of alright, isn't it? Wow, I went very insultingly British on that. I apologize. Insultingly bad British, I guess I should have said, but anyway. Come on. Oh, not wall eject. Climb jump. There you go. There you go, Arno. There you go, buddy. Ba-ba-na-ba-na-ba-na-ba-da-na-ba-na-na. Well, all right. Warning, leap of faith inbound. Ooh, I have cherry bombs. Oh, sorry, didn't know that was another leap of faith about to happen. Rebirth. Now that Arno is out of prison, it's time to track down Bellick and get some answers from the old man.
I suppose a simple address would be too mundane.
Yeah. For the assassins, yeah. That is a gorgeous church interior.
Perhaps the sunbeam.
Almost unreal, yeah. This is when the queen's just like, okay, so I have to go to Paris now. Next year. Ooh. Fancy.
You should totally take me, your best friend, with you.
It would be a lot of fun. Arrested by the French police. No, not really. Arno. Whoa! Arno! Oh, God. Arno. Dude. Missed the opportunity, my guy. Fine, I'll go back. Yeah, getting arrested by the Paris police while we get, because we get in trouble for, climbing all over the interior of these churches, right? Because they did it in Assassin's Creed, so it must be okay, right? 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 All right, so it is timed. That's an important thing to keep in mind. Woo! Almost missed that. Come on. Up, up. There you go. Up. Arno! Please? Because everyone knows that anything that happens in a video game must be okay in real life. Gestures broadly at things like Call of Duty.
Enough, Pisspot. What is this place? The sanctuary. A place we can train and prepare away from the eyes of our enemies.
Didn't we just escape from a dungeon?
It's not a dungeon. It's a nerve center. From these tunnels, we can get anywhere in the city. All without being seen. We have eyes everywhere.
Really? Seems visibility would be a problem. Wouldn't you prefer something with a view?
This place has served us well for 600 years, Pisspot.
Mm-hmm. And how long were you standing in the dark waiting for me?
Not long. Guillaume spotted you from the bell tower.
Well, it was quite the entrance.
Are you mocking me?
No, no. God's truth, very theatrical.
Shut up. We're here.
The candidate will approach.
So, the son of Charles Dorion returns to us. Belek thought you wouldn't come, but changed your mind.
I'm tired of running from my failures. Monsieur de Lacerre, my father. I want to make it right.
The death of Grandmaster de Lacerre weighs on you. Why? Did you wield the blade yourself?
Does it matter? The blame still lies with me.
He carries his guilt heavily. Are you sure of this one? I am. He can face the trials. He can be great.
Very well. Out of the dark, you come into the light. From the light, you will return to the dark. Are you prepared to travel the Eagle's path?
If that's a fancy way of asking, do I want your help? Yes.
Then drink.
Real quick, this man who's at the center, the one who just said then drink, we actually saw him talking to de la Serre earlier, though I don't think they're going to let you realize that just yet. He was the one that Arno overheard discussing with de la Serre what would replace a king if the populace got what they wanted. And they mentioned it, and they said something about a truce. And then later that night, de la Serre was murdered by his own compatriots. And framed Arno for it. Drugs.
What's happening? Hello?
Called LSD. Nectus. Querulous, whatever. Juventus, Adultus, Mortis. The fact that that statue is following me with her eyes is not, you know, it's totally fine.
Father!
Where is that boy? I'm certain it's 6 o'clock. We should be well away by now.
Father, it's me! I'm here!
He was waiting for Arno when Shay Cormac murdered him.
there's how Shay murdered him. Because Arno never actually saw the murder, he doesn't know what Shay looks like. L. Fight happening between Monsieur de la Serre and his attacker.
If you could put your head from your own arse, come find us. We can fight for you.
If I leave it here, Monsieur de la Serre will see it the instant he returns.
However, that was too late.
You seem to have caused quite a commotion.
What can I say? You were always a bad influence.
Truly, I am blessed to have such a loyal.
He's killed Lord de la Serre.
Sorry, give me a second. I need to check that I didn't fuck something up. Come on. Okay. Okay. Sorry. Somebody liked a tweet I posted on Friday, and I was suddenly panicking, thinking that the tweet I posted today about tonight's stream was that I filled in the wrong thing, you know, that I posted the wrong tweet about today's stream. Whew. Natus. Birth. Youth. Adulthood. Even this is youth. Wireless. And death. Look at all these hooded people. Arno and his father. Arno's father and de la Serre. Player desynchronized. Kill the assassin, kill the man who killed the people without being detected. You think you're gonna go to sleep? All right, my stream will be done in about 16-ish minutes, but you know, yeah, I aim for 10 usually. Okay, as long as you're sure. You're the one who has to work in the morning. And no body. So he didn't actually kill anyone.
These are the words spoken by our ancestors, the words that lay at the heart of our creed.
Stay your blade from the flesh of the innocent.
Hide in plain sight.
Never compromise the Brotherhood.
Let these tenets be branded upon your mind. Follow them and be uplifted. Break them at your peril.
Rise, assassin.
Arno Dorian is dead. He has been culled from this world, his sins and failures turned to dust. Tonight he is reborn, a novice of the Assassin Brotherhood.
In fact, actually, I think we're going to call it there, because that's a pretty good place to call it, depending on what happens after this loading. But we'll see, because that's a pretty damn good place to call it, you know? So we'll see what happens after this loading screen. Again, cool. Yep. I don't know why this game takes so long to load. I have it on an SSD.
Welcome back. Now that you've experienced life as an assassin, are you willing to pick up the fight and join us? Deacon, load the file.
Coming up.
We lifted a media file from Abstergo last month, and the information it contains is astounding. But we won't share these things with just anyone. By pressing play, you'll be joining the assassins. If you want to fight the Templar menace, if you're willing to save civilization from Abstergo's clutches, press play, sit back, and ready yourself for the truth. Good choice. Welcome to the Assassins, Initiate.
Level 5 security clearance only. For internal use only. Gregor Mendel, Albrecht, a bunch of other names.
In the 1950s, it was theorized that human DNA worked via the triple helix model. Some years later, the work of Crick and Watson demolished this theory in favor of the double helix. Today, we know the double helix to be indisputably the basis of all life. So why did the triple helix theory gain so much traction? Why did Rosalind Franklin's X-rays seem to confirm it? It turns out that their initial samples had been taken from small traces of precursor DNA, the rare genes of an ancient race embedded in our own. We now know that triple helix DNA is the foundation of the precursor genome. It is the genetic Rosetta Stone of our age. If we can crack it open, if we can sequence the full precursor genome, there is no limit to the knowledge we will gain. Using Animus technology, precursor history will be open to us for the first time ever. Ancient languages will be unlocked, and ancient technology will be ours for the taking. Imagine what will be possible if we master the technology that underpins the pieces of Eden. Such discoveries would surpass 100-fold the splitting of the atom. Last year, we located a rich sample of precursor DNA in a donor whose genes contained human and precursor DNA at an incredible donor 25-to-1 ratio. Our work will begin with this sample. Our goal is to unravel the triple helix, sequence the precursor genome, and change the world for the better, forever. Welcome to the Phoenix Project.
John Standish was the sage, the modern-day sage that tried to kill the noob at the end of Assassin's Creed 4. He was the one who was the, he was also the man known as Erudito.
Last year, Abstergo acquired the body of a man we call a sage, one of a rare breed of humans with a surplus of ancient DNA. This sparked a search for more sages, in the present and in the past. The more Abstergo finds, the closer they get to their final goal. We've blocked their recent attempts to find more, but Abstergo will not stop looking until they sequence a full precursor genome. So, why Arno Dorian? Why chase an assassin through the French Revolution? It turns out, at some point in his life, Arno came into contact with another sage. We need you to find out when and where these meetings took place. If Arno was present for this sage's death, it might lead Abstergo straight to his body. Naturally, we'd like to find it first. This is where you come in. It won't be simple. Genetic memory must be tackled in sequence to keep the data stable. But we're confident you're up to the task. And you won't be alone. Other initiates, assassins just like you, are doing their part to end this fight. If you need more training, more experience, you can call on them for help. All right. Loading the next sequence.
Paris, January 4th, 1791.
I've got something else for you. The more time you spend with Arno, the more data we'll have to increase your synchronization with him and to activate his abilities. Here, have a look at this.
Assassin abilities unlocked. Your new assassin abilities have been unlocked in your skills menu. Ranged weapon, assassin cache, money pouch, stun grenade, communal sense, disguise, apprentice locksmith, group healing, double assassination, thick skin, environmental blending, and staggering strike. Let's put this first. Communal sense, shaler, air, eagle vision among allied players. Disguise, the ability to temporarily disguise yourself and nearby allies as a selected target. Apprentice locksmith, I think that's the one I want. Environmental blending, double assassination, ranged. Get that. Oops. What was this? Melee. Staggering strike. No. Health. Group healing. Thick skin. Assassination's 4. I can't get that. Environmental blending. I'll get that. And then I'll get the ranged weapon. Like, those are the ones that wanted me to get, because they're the lowest. Okay.
One last thing. While you've been busy, I had Deacon do some poking around in Arno's memories. Seems he was a busy guy. See that symbol? That's a co-op mission. I play a lot of games multiplayer. I don't know about you, but I thought you'd like to mix it up a little. These are missions Arno ran with his assassin buddies, so they'll give you an idea of what our organization's about. Just walk into the glitch and you'll get all the details. I've marked them on your map.
All right. Alright, we're gonna actually call it there. Because it's 6 till. But let's take a quick look at us at Arno's assassin outfit here. Look at that. Right? He looks really great, Queen. As we level him up throughout the game, his outfit, we will get access to better and better different outfits and things like that. And each outfit, because this is a bit RPG-ish, each outfit has abilities and things. Like, I could choose colors if I wanted to. I could have him... So, like, here... Those are his default colors, right? The assassin, blue, brown, and gray. We could do some other variations thereon. Peaceful Tales with the white, red, dark brown, which is very traditional assassin. With the red and the white. And then, of course, you know. You know. You know. But again, I'm not actually going to use it. Because I want to keep it as canon as possible. And this is his canon outfit. So here are some different outfits. Because I've played this game before, a lot of them have already been unlocked. The gray and white one? Yeah. But again, because I've played this game before, a lot of them have already been unlocked, as you can see. Some of them require progression unlocked to unlock them. Certain missions and stuff. As you can see here. But, so, the default outfit is Arno's original hood, right? Then there's that. Arno's tailor hood, which is the next level... the next, level up. These are all different, variants. They give... See how they give different boosts? This gives a boost to health, this gives a boost to, nothing. This gives health and stealth. This gives stealth. The handmade Napoleonic hood gives health and stealth. Handmade medieval hood gives a lot of health. Handmade bourgeois hood is health and stealth. So on and so forth. So like there's the Arno set, right? Which is just variations upon this one. By the end of it... where is it? Is that it? No. There it is. Arno's Masterhood. Which sounds a little, you know. But anyway. So he gets a different variation, and the same thing is true with the chest pieces as well. The master coat looks like that. Excuse me. Arno's original bracers. Where are they? Master bracers. Etc., so on and so forth. And then on top of that, there's also different base outfits. So we've got Altair's outfit, Bellex Master Assassin outfit, Shay's Templar coat, Connor's Assassin outfit, Edward's Assassin outfit, Ezio's Assassin outfit, Thomas de Carneillon, he was the assassin that we followed, that we were chasing at the start of the game, at the tragedy of Jacques Molay sequence. Arno's Fearless outfit, which was an early concept art for the design for the outfit of Arno. The McFarlane variant, designed by Todd McFarlane. Then there's his actual Master Assassin outfit, with all its gold trim and stuff. The difference between this and the equipment version of it is that this has special gold trim that's a sign that you have completed all single player sequences. Raider outfit, Iron Mask. So if you've ever seen the Man in the Iron Mask, well, there it is. And Napoleon's artillery outfit and stuff, so on and so forth. But yeah, you have a lot of customization options. You can have one-handed weapons, long weapons like spears and whatnot, heavy weapons like axes and stuff, and heavy swords, pistols, of course, rifles, of course, and what's called the guillotine gun, which is both a heavy weapon and a fucking blunderbuss. Cause you know, why the fuck not? But yeah. This is all stuff that I will be messing with and managing and evolving on my own off of stream, most likely. So that you guys don't have to get bogged down with it. Yeah. Anyway. We're gonna call it there for the night. Can I get on top of the statue? Yes, let me perch on his head. Okay. We're gonna call it there for the night. Come on, Arno, look at the camera. There we go. We're gonna call it there for the night. I hope you all have been enjoying this. I certainly am. I loved Assassin's Creed Unity. Like I said at the top of the stream, tomorrow I'm gonna be, instead of Tomb Raider Tuesday, I'm gonna be doing a little special thing with Yvonne to celebrate her 3 years on Twitch. And oops, wrong button. I want this button. So make sure you absolutely, if you aren't following her, go check her out at Yvonne B, twitch.tv/YvonneB, right there. I have other recommendations, as you can see on screen. I have even more recommendations in that link tree right down there. In fact, if you go to that link tree, you'll find links to my YouTube, where you can watch all my VODs a week after I stream them, in case you miss any of them or want to rewatch any of them for free. Also, you'll find a link to my Patreon, where you can support me directly if you so choose for $1 a month. Or you can, there's also links to my socials and my Discord and things like that. So you can hang out with me and my friends on Discord, or you can follow my socials for updates about my stream, when I'll be streaming, what I'll be streaming, and so on and so forth. But that's it. Like I said, that's it from me for the night. Tomorrow I'm coming back to celebrate Yvonne's 3-year anniversary on Twitch tomorrow. But until then, remember to have empathy, be kind, be safe, love yourselves, and love everyone around you. And I will see you all tomorrow. I love you all. Peace out.